Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to simracing.org 24 hours of Daytona. As you've seen, possibly, we have a problem straight away, and hopefully we won't miss the start, but we're already getting into things, trying to fix it. But for the meantime, I'll give you the rundown through the grid. Qualifying happened last night, and it was another pole position for Karsten in the GRL XF Racing. It seems to be a really good track for the Audis and Ferraris, so it could be another good battle between Marius and Anderson like last time out. In third place is Daniel High in the teammate's car of Karsten, so it's a 1-3 for GRL, which is pretty good for them. And in fourth position is RSR Gaming Team 1, driven by Luigi. In fifth place is Rico in the RC SKS team. Sixth position is another rail car, driven by Matthias. Seventh position is All-Star Racing Team 1, driven by Stefan. In eighth position is Dirk in the Wilgrave GTR 30 team. In ninth position is Sasha. Tenth position is RML Racing Team 1, driven by Nicholas. David is driving the Independent Sim Racer GT1 in the 11th place. 12th place is Brandek in Racing Team 1. 13th place is Witchwood, driven by Alex Piccolo. I think they're a team to watch out for, as there have been rumours they have really quick drivers for this race. In 14th is Andreas Smish in the All-Star Racing Team 1, or Team 2, sorry. RML is right behind them, driven by CG. Ronald Hanel is Independent Sim Racer, bringing out the top 16 so far, and all within a second nearly of the quickest time. Yeah, so we have our pitchers back and we could be underway. Yeah, so here we go. The start of Daytona 24 hours. And I am joined by Reed, who should be with me now, but he isn't. So, yes.
Hello!
Now, so I am joined by Mr. Wayne Reed himself.
Yep, hello. I'm here. Technical issues fixed.
At the start race.
Yep, as per usual in the English stream, you know, it all works spliffingly well. Start as you mean to go on is the motto.
Yep.
So, we're looking like Mr. Maris already on the offensive here as well. It's, you know, straight into the racing. Oh, hang on, we've got a driver off there already. He's going to have to pay to get back in.
Yeah, it could be a penalty for the corner. We heard some drivers saying the miss your breaking points, you end up cutting the corner and you could get a penalty for that. So I don't think it's worth pushing that hard through there. It's worth just being a bit safe and not getting up to.
Yeah, very nasty curbs going through that chicane as well. You know, it's can you get in there wrong? And as many of us have discovered through testing, it's very easy to find a wall. So, you know, especially, yeah. You know, lap one of probably a good 500 laps and be pushing that hard is a bit silly. Also, you probably notice there on their broadcast that we've got cars with blue flashing lights. This is a new feature that they've added for this event, that the top 10 qualifiers now get a blue flashing light in their car. So it's something new. I don't actually understand the full why it's been done. You know, maybe it's to frighten the bat markers out of the way, maybe they think they've got the police behind them, but
yeah, I think it's a good idea up to bat markers. At least the bat markers know there's a much faster car coming up, as we see Marius really on an attack now, and it's at least also what you can see in his mirror clearly, he's really under attack. So top three really pulling away from Luigi in the RSR.
I mean, I think we saw, didn't we, last race at Marius Burke's got some serious speed, I know, through when we was testing on the server. It was going some. I mean, last night's qualifying pace was absolutely incredible, with Carsten doing a 42.8, I think the time was, which was just mind-blowingly quick. I mean, no one was touching that in testing during the week. Was, you know, it was sort of late 43, so quite where he pulled it from, I don't actually know.
Exactly, and just to update people on this championship, GRL, they've been using the Alpina B6 for the last few races, but the top two leading teams now, they both changed to an Audi R8, so, but they still have the third team on the BMW as a backup, as they know that car inside out by now. But it seems like they can make any car go quick.
Yeah, I mean, definitely something to be holding, obviously, after mishaps of the last race at Eastern Creek, when they had an unfortunate disconnect with about half hour remaining, resulted in them losing the race. I think they came fifth in that, so they're obviously wanting to put that right this time round and take the 24 hour victory. So hopefully, you know, best of luck to them and all the other teams that we don't get the disconnect issue again.
Yes, as we've seen, Marius just missing the back of Carson there and just running a bit wide, but is able to square it up for the corner and get back on the power.
Yeah, it seems Daniel Hack has now all of a sudden found the pace and he's pressuring Marius Burt. This is going to get quite good here. It's going to be interesting to see. We know these three drivers are mega clean and mega quick, so, you know, is it going to spread out or are we going to be all out racing for the next 24 hours?
Yeah, also the times we've seen about 1:44 down the back of the grid, and these guys are doing 1:44 in the race, so already very quick pace, and the tyres still have to heat up fully, and so very impressive.
We've also got, just looking there, we've got Satellite Racing Team 1, which is driven at the minute by Sean Yoder. He's in the pit, so don't quite know whether he's an accident somewhere or a disconnect already. Let's put them quite far back. So hopefully they can find some pace and come along. Here we go, we've got an overtake going on with Marius Burt.
Yes, I'll try back to that now.
There we go. Daniel Hacker tries to go around the outside into turn one. It's a very risky manoeuvre around there. Sort of only really one quick line through that.
Yep.
Cost you a lot of time if you get that one wrong.
Well, we've seen it done in race, being done around the outside by one of the GRL guys, so it's possible, but in the race, I wouldn't risk.
No, certainly not this early stage as well, you know. It's, you don't want to be crashing your car and having a lot of damage to repair, put you right back. Put a lot of wheel lock in there from Daniel Hacker. He's desperate to find a way past.
Yeah.
I think he wants Carsten running away. At the minute, Carsten is getting away, not by a lot, but he's starting to gap with these two fighting with each other now.
Yeah, it'd be interesting though. I think, would you let the quicker car pass and try work with them to get up to Carsten? But being it's Carsten's teammates, so they might hold them up. So it'll be interesting now to see, will they battle so much that they'll end up losing a lot of time to the leader?
If I was Daniel, I'd use the bump draft technique, I do believe. I don't think it's been banned for this event. I think that's their best way around it, is Daniel can use Marius bump draft, obviously, around the banking sections and try and pull that gap back.
Yeah, but it's very risky though in T-racing. It's, I don't know if it's really worth it. Maybe just slipstream past him and just get on with the job. And here we go, around the outside.
Yeah, this will be interesting to see. We know the R8 is very, very quick in a straight line round there. Is he going to find the space he's got past? Can he swing it around the outside? He's going to be on the brakes. That was beautiful.
And he does it.
Absolutely beautiful.
Yep.
Now that, boys and girls, that's how you overtake in sim racing without wiping each other off. So let's see now what other battles we've got going on. We've only got Racing Association are just behind Wychwood. We'll go and see what's going on here. This is Jan Titz and Alex Piccolo are fighting for 10th and 11th.
Actually, oh, interesting to see Lugini there.
Yeah, we've got another. That's Bjorn Deck. That's for GP Racing Team. Not seen them before. They must be a new team in for this event. So welcome to the championship.
Speaking of new teams, we are running a team ourselves called the Broadcast Team, which is a 4GT. At the moment, it's in 21st position, so for the first race with the three drivers all meeting for the first time. It's not bad, and it is delivery done by Luke Walsh, who's driving it at the moment. Yeah, so under attack, car looks pretty settled, as is set up by Simtech Motorsport. Hehehe.
Plug,
had to be said.
I think we're just about to lose a position to the R8 then.
Yeah, but at least he didn't try to block a stupid move, and he just kept it clean and let him pass.
We've got somebody in the pits already. Let's see who this is going in here. Let's have a look. Come on, update timing. There we go. That is Lazy Man Racing.
Update. It's
Bastion
RML.
Nigel.
No, I think it's RML.
No, it's changed, yeah. Put him in timing. Wants to make its mind out who's in the pits and who isn't.
Yeah.
Oh, dear. I wonder why they've pitted so early. Must have sustained damage early on there. Let's have a little... See if we can ever see. Alright, we'll have a... If I can get my cameras to work and do as they're told. There we go.
Yeah, it doesn't look like much damage. Maybe just accidentally selected qualifying setup with only a few laps in it, so...
Yeah.
That's interesting.
Yeah. It's either that or we've missed the damage going on. Obviously, with an R factor, it puts the damage as soon as you stop it, puts any body parts that are missing straight back on. Got another overtake going on there as well. Ferrari up the inside.
The Racing Association.
No, he's backed out of that.
There's
always going to be a door that was going to close that one. There's only really one line through there. It's all going off at the back.
Yeah. And here we go, Witchwood going around the outside possibly. We're right on board with Racing Association, could get a good feel of the draft and...
Yeah. Ooh. Draft times two.
Could be three side by side.
Oh, Jesus
Christ!
Somebody wasn't looking in their mirrors. Crikey. That could have been a nasty accident, that one. He's been
and they're all running wide.
Flimmin' heck.
Ooh. That's exciting stuff.
Somebody wasn't happy there, flashing their lights up. It's oh dearie me, what are you doing?
Oh,
this shouldn't be racing like this
actually,
at this early stage.
Actually, this team's been in trouble during the week in test races with their drivers getting suspensions for this race and getting time penalties, so it's not an revenge back at them, so I think this will turn into a very dirty battle at the moment, and it wouldn't surprise me if it'll end in tears.
Yes, I could see the... we've got Ray Stewart in for this event due to some of the mishaps that have been going on, so they want to be very careful, because if they keep that up, they could well find themselves with a stop-and-go penalty. You know, they need to calm it down. It's
exactly.
You know, the race has only been going 17 minutes now of a 24-hour event, and they're racing like we've got 17 minutes left. He's letting through there for some reason, flashed and letting past. Oh dear, that went wrong, going a bit squirmish on the brakes there.
Oh,
and he's just pulled straight onto the racing line. Dearie me.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's worse just slowing down a bit and not doing that. Now you could have a penalty easily and basically the race could be over.
And we seem to be in the grandstands. What's going on there?
Wow.
There we go. Got a bit of server lag there. We've got four in the mix of this position now. Oh dear. That's all gone.
Oh.
Oh, we've got someone into the wall.
To Lamborghini and suspension damage for the Ferrari. He's been hit on the left hand side pretty hard, and unless it's maybe lag or something we're getting, but
yeah, something's going on here because my live timing's only displaying 12 positions as well, so can't know what's going on here.
My timing's not working at all, and the server's gone funny. and everyone's lagging on me.
yeah, I'm getting lag as well. I do hope it's not interfering too much with people viewing. I do apologise for what's going on. Seem to be having some technical issues.
Yes, maybe a switch card might help, but I doubt that.
We seem to have no cars left. And we've got a crash.
Not going our way today.
No, it's not going well at all. We'll leave it a couple of minutes. We seem to have had a server crash, so we'll let the guys sort the server issues out.
One of our viewers is complaining that the server is lagging a lot.
Yeah, so, right. We seem to, I think the server's back up, so we'll try and rejoin proceedings. So we'll go into, if it's a server failure, we'll go into a race restart.
No, so if anyone wants to come in for an interview later, please do. Just contact me on Facebook, which you'll find me through the broadcast team Facebook page, or you can find me on Twitter at TheRealSB. And I'm more than happy to interview anyone that's involved with any motorsport and whatever.
Oh, I'm in motorsport.
Yeah.
I'm hairdryer racing. Right, we seem to be back. Everyone's still joining the server. So, we'll... we'll see what's going on. There we go. Right, we'll go back live now. So, we just now wait for the teams and that to get underway again. So, obviously having server difficulties there. Everybody disconnected on the live timing, so it's definitely a server failure, unfortunately. So it's a shame we're only 20 minutes in, so we've got to do it all again, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, but I think great racing in first 20 minutes or so it's worth it in a way. They'll be back close together and... But it'd be interesting to see, will they go back to their qualifying positions or their race positions where they finished there? So, yeah, I hope they go to qualifying, as that created the great grid.
Yeah, it's a pity we've had this, I know, after the incidents with the 24 hours of Nordschleife. It was, we'd changed the hosting servers due to the issues that they was having. It seems that we're now having problems again. I blame Shane.
Yep.
These problems only seem to happen when he's around.
Yep.
So much for the lucky charm part of you coming out there in the Irish blood.
Yeah. Yeah, it seems to be going wrong today.
Nice. I think it was the shenanigans of last night, the enjoyment we was having on TeamSpeak, eh, Shane?
Yeah, I think I'm bad luck. I'm surprised I'm not fired yet.
Just being messaged by someone. Let's have a look. Where is he? Where are you?
Yeah, so later tonight we'll talk about random stuff.
Alex Piccolo is the one that's been driving like a man possessed. I'm getting quite a few messages here at the minute. There's a few drivers coming out with they're scared of his undisrespectful driving towards others, and I'd certainly second that. So I'm in agreement there with you. He certainly needs to calm his behaviour down. I mean, as we know, the stewards are watching this, so he may well have received a message just to say calm it down a bit.
Yeah, exactly. The crazy aliens.
So, we're just waiting here. Hang on. Someone's... Shane,
nope,
what
Sky.
Are you doing? What are you doing?
I haven't touched it.
You lemon.
Wow, that's a lovely road.
Yeah, look at that, see?
That's
there we
great
go.
Surface.
Oh, dear. Yeah, maybe one seems to be reconnecting, so I think that we'll what we'll do is we'll stick ourselves there, so then when they come out, seems to be, I think the starting order's yet to be sorted. Just have to bear with the admin, there's a lot to sort out. Have to reorganise everybody. We'll keep you up to date once it starts again. We'll be back with the action. So
yeah.
So you'll have to, you know, I hear you've your new PC should be arriving any time soon, Mr. Burke.
Yeah, hopefully arrive and I can do some racing again, as I can't do much racing at all because of my PC being very, very bad. I would have used a different word if it was past 9 o'clock. A very different word. But yeah, hopefully I can take part in Silverstone if all goes to plan.
Yep, so to all the other teams out there, watch yourselves because the Renegade's coming for you.
Yes, just don't go near me, go around me or something. I know, I'm not that bad.
No. Yeah, it's it's kind of bizarre, you know. We've had Giovanni Keeney was banned from this race due to pretty much not even as bad as the kind of race we're seeing by Alex Piccolo. It seems, you know, one driver being given a punishment of a ban due to bad driving doesn't seem to have, you know, sunk in with others that you can get banned. So I do think there's going to be a few protests from at least 3 cars there. Driving like that's just completely disrespectful and absolutely unneeded.
Yeah, it's the annoying thing though about sim racing is when you're like in a battle, you don't really think of hitting someone, or you just go for the move. But then in real life, you have that thing in your head where you're like, okay, I won't do that because I could end up hurting someone or myself. So it's the only thing in sim racing that I dislike, because that part of your head doesn't think, so you just end up doing stupid things.
Yeah, I mean, it's one of those things. He's obviously started either further back than he wanted to, or he's had a mishap at the start. Someone's playing musical instruments. And it's, you know, I think he's just trying to push way too hard, and being that aggressive, he's obviously gone for the standpoint that, you know, if I show my nose, I'm going to frighten people, and at the end of the day, what are you doing? Oh dear, we've got another issue here again.
I'm in.
You're eating what? You're eating your pineapples again, are you?
Yeah.
Dear me, we've got another... We've had another crash on our end now. This is going well.
Wow, we're not even an hour in. Actually, we're not even half an hour in.
No, but we're doing well because they're all still in, apparently. I'm looking at the timing, so it's just the broadcast side of things, because our German colleagues have also been kicked because I've seen them just rejoin. So it seems we're having some issues, as is the way. You know, Sky Sports has got nothing on us. Oh dear, they're fun and games, eh? They're fun and games. What better way to spend your Saturday afternoon than keep logging into our factor? Are you enjoying your bits of
Yeah, I'm just done them. Pretty nice.
I'll tell you, you're risking it having that on top of the curry you had last night.
Yeah. So working the server again. Whoop de doo. Yep.
I'm just waiting for it to respond so I can do my stuff.
If anyone wants a shout out, you might as well send us a message now, as nothing's really happening.
No. Maybe.
But later tonight, I guess we'll talk about the real world oozing Formula One and random stuff to keep everyone entertained. in the late hours of the morning.
Ah, there we go, we got movement. That's what we wanted.
Mm-hmm.
So, let's get back to business. And we won again.
We hope.
We want to... So there we go. Seems a couple of the drivers are being released. Right, let's try and go... Oh, hang on, what's happened here? There we go. We go back to our live pictures. And hopefully we can stay here. Right, so... let's go on. There we go. This is your race leader. The man that started on pole position. Seems we're starting the start procedure now. The admins have put everyone in the position. Start procedure basically goes along the lines of each team is associated a number where they qualified. The league admins will put a message up with that number in. The cars will follow out in number order and form up on the grid. They have two laps, possibly three if needed, to form up behind each other. They drive round at about 30 mile an hour. We then do the formation on the grid. The flag will go green. We do one racing formation lap, and on the next go round, we go full speed racing.
Yeah, it seems to be speed bumping cars, haven't it?
Yep, or as we can see, Carson's got a massive lead coming out the end of the pit lane.
Oh, it's getting closed down now. Could be a battle for the lead any second.
And what we just welcome everybody into the GT3 League. This is the economy run. The league got taken over by the FIA, and we're now using lawnmower engines because they burn less. As you can see, it's high speed action.
So, from this position, so we are starting with the order that we finished with there. So,
yep.
I have the two teammates battling it out.
Yeah, this is going to be interesting. We have Daniel and Carsten fighting it out. We still need a nickname for Carsten. We're yet to find one, so if anyone's got any ideas, give us a shout on Facebook, Facebook/the broadcast team. If we can come up with a nickname for Mr. Willem. Because we were struggling to find something that rhymes with his name.
Yeah, so... the cars are getting ready now, and hopefully we'll be going back to racing again. But for now, we are watching cars run very, very slowly.
Yeah, this is all forming up now. 30, I think it's 30 is the maximum they're allowed to drive at, so... it's basically a bit of form up behind. See, we use this procedure because of the plug-in. We use the rejoin plug-in, which means the race is run in practice mode, so the qualifying results can't be carried across as such. They have to be given out by the league admin. It's a bit of stress for the league admins, but it's well worth it for what the plug-in brings us, as it means that every single team that starts can finish. So, you still get the discos, but it enables you to rejoin, and you'll end up... You receive a time penalty when this happens, but it means, after 4 weeks of testing, if you get wiped out or, you have an accident into turn one, you're not straight out of the race. And if anybody's ever done enduro racing, knows when you come out after putting a lot of effort in, it's quite heartbreaking.
Yeah, it's a very good plug. I think, personally, it only should be used if you get disconnection. And, well, I guess, in a way... if you do have a bad crash, like in real life, you can bring the car back sometimes and get it fixed, but that will take a while, so it all depends on the situation. But personally, it's a good idea, and luckily some leagues run this as I was in a race myself, a 24-hour race, and a simple swap fail, which never happened to us before, knocked us out of the race, and pretty heartbreaking. So, fair play to the simracing.org guys for bringing us this great bit of stuff, yeah.
Yeah, it's definitely something I should be using in the Grand Am League that we'll be doing. It's with the DP cars and GT3s. I think it's going to make that quite a fantastic event. You know, we'll definitely be doing the 24 Hours of Daytona with that, so which is going to be brilliant, having the DP cars in there.
Can you give out the name of the website yet?
Yep, it's... No, hang on.
No.
I've got to remember the end of it. I can't remember if it's org or com. Hang on, I'll tell you. I don't use that. I access it through the back end, so it's... I've only used it on the one occasion. Let me just... It's a professionally run site, you know.
yeah. Who are you hiring then?
Well, I was going to get you to run it, you know. No, hang on. We've got a post on Facebook. Dimitri said that you've made it lag.
Well, yeah, I probably didn't all, but has to be done. It's tradition now.
Yeah, and bringing the commentator's curse.
Yep. Wait until I put some current through a wall again.
Yeah, it'll be simpromasters.com. But you won't see nothing yet. Since the final stages. We'll be going live this week. And that'll be that. Many events coming. Got a karting league coming up as well. We have Formula Ford in the future. And quite a few other bits and pieces for people to come and join in with.
Yeah, especially should the karting, as it's pretty close racing and good fun at the same time, very, very challenging. So, and it will be run by the one and only me, which will probably end up trashing it and crashing servers, but hopefully it won't go that bad for me.
Yeah, just to let everyone know, I'll do the server operation side of things, and
thankfully.
But we'll also be looking for commentators for that as well. So anyone interested in getting into commentating, you're certainly, you know, bring yourselves forward. Give us, you know, message us on Facebook or anywhere else you can find us. I'm on there, obviously, Wayne Reed, you've got Shane Burton. Shane's also got a Twitter account. I think it's the Real SP or something or other like that. And
yep.
You know, give us a shout and we'll give you all the training that's needed. It's not as scary as you think it is. It's very enjoyable. It's you know, you'll have a great laugh with doing
great
it.
Great laugh. And,
you know, certainly if there's any, you know, German-speaking commentators as well, you know, we're up for running two streams and bits and pieces. So bring yourselves forward and make yourselves known. Yeah. But the actual racing that we're supposed to be commentating on, it's We're still forming up. I've received another message. There we go. We've got one person's already interested in joining the commentating team, Mr. Connor Kane. So we'll certainly speak to you on Monday afternoon after I've slept for about 6 days, after staying up for a 24-hour event, speak to you and give you some training. You know, we'll maybe bring you in one of these events so you can get your teeth into it and see what it's all about.
Actually, he's a carter himself, so he's pretty good at content, I'd say, if he does it.
Yeah, it's certainly helpful, you know, for all you fellow carters out there. So
yeah.
It's a bit of Carson there, doing some 11s.
Yeah.
I think we're more or less formed. I don't think we're waiting. There's nobody else in the pits, as far as I can tell, on the live timing. We're all out and about. Just us lot sat in there now, so we're just a matter of waiting. Everyone will just form up, and I think we go round for a formation, then a grid line up, and then we're off. Oh, look at that! Look, there's a pond in the middle there. Never noticed that before.
Wow! Might go for swimming. It's later.
Yeah. You watch out for the big white sharks in there, eh?
Yeah, might eat. Wouldn't be a good way to end commentating.
Yeah, I can't see the commentating team working as trying to pull off a Red Bull stunt jumping into the pond, to be honest.
No.
I mean, you generally need to win something for that to happen, and with how slow you are at racing, there's not much chance of you winning anything, really.
It'd be handy to have the seats kind of up so the crowd could sit in the grandstand there. It's kind of hard to sit down when it's all, like, closed.
Yeah, but it's certainly something as well that needs, I think, needs adjusting that when they do these tracks for these events, because they're done in the practice session, is to enable the spectators to be there in the practice mode. Here we go, we're going to get up to a high-speed formation now. Because obviously, you know, we're watching it and there's no spectators there because it's running practice mode. It's be better to have a few spectators, you know, taking pictures and wearing the team caps and all the rest of it in there. It's got to be done.
Yeah, and that's a fairly big house behind.
Yeah, it's where the BFG lives, I believe.
So now it's back to the racing, I think. As we're back up to speed. Yeah, so up to speed again. We'll be going side by side in the last part of the track as they prepare for the 24 hours of Daytona, or it could be 23 hours 20 minutes, I'm not sure.
Yep, or it could be 23 minutes.
The way it's going, God knows.
Well, we could end up with 24 hours of sprint racing. Is this us underway? Or are we in formation? No, it can't be, we're not getting any air, we're still weaving. I was going to say, that was a bit of a... They all seemed to slow down for a minute there and then went again, you know, can't deal with the stress.
Yeah, I think these tires are very hard to get heat into and get them to the right temperature, so everyone's driving pretty hard at moments, and a bit risky though on cold tires, you could easily throw it into the wall.
Yeah, and we will also be, at certain times throughout the 24 hours, we are going to be going into the broadcast team. We're going to be sending Shane down into the pit lane with his sun cream on. He's going to go down and have a word and see how they're getting on, you know, and give you a bit more feedback as to what it's like for these drivers doing what they're doing.
Yep, but not at the moment because tension is high and I think every driver needs full focus at the moment.
Yep, definitely, and we need to keep you away for a while because otherwise you'll be straight to the burger and chips wagons and I can't be doing with that in here with your greasy fingers all over me keyboard.
Nope.
Although saying that, I did pig out on burger and chips just before the broadcast started.
You know, I love a burger and chips right now.
That was in real life as well. I must admit, it's probably one of the first times I've sat here having burger and chips at 11:30.
Yeah.
It's a needs new must. Well, you got to have your munchies, ain't you? I've got all my crisps and chocolate and everything there, you know. It's when you've worked with the greats as Simon Smith, you kind of, you know, you learn the tricks of the trade. You need plenty of munchies for these 24-hour events.
I have none. I've after eating all my food and I'm going to starve for debt now, so.
Has your dad not been shopping again?
Kinda, yeah.
Well, it was his birthday.
I said it's Jaffa Cakes.
Happy birthday, Mr. Burke.
Yeah, so I think we could be getting underway.
Yep, we're getting into formation now. This is it. Let's see if Mr. Piccolo calms himself down at all.
Yeah, so here we go. Many hours to go. So any second now, and there we go. Or there.
There we go, and the green flag drops, and we're underway.
Yep, looks like everyone's all bunched up together. Will they stay clean? Yep.
Piling in, I think we've all got through to turn one. Just a good start there, then. Nice to see, we haven't had any mishaps. Is it Carsten's trying to break away? Yeah, these two are gapping already. Daniel's not letting him go, though. Carsten's severely under pressure now. And there's the police car there, driven by Daniel Hacker.
pull over, you're speeding. Oh, could be
well. Okay, steady on, son, steady on there. He's just shouting through the window. Pull over there, and Carson's shouting back now. It's a cardigan, but thanks for noticing.
You can actually see a difference in the driving style. Carson brakes a bit earlier, kind of smoother into the corner and just gets on the power, where Daniel is way deeper on the brakes but has to stop it up a bit more through the corner and a bit later onto the accelerator.
Yeah, it seems to be Carson's a bit quicker in a straight line. I'm wondering if they're running a little less wing. As Daniel seems to pull it back on a bit of slip there, but he is definitely quicker off out the corners, that's for certain. Cool, there's a bit of grass cutting there, Mr. Hacker.
Yep. Oops.
Have we got Mr. Piccolo anywhere? What's he getting up to?
Think we'll check in a minute after this.
Here we go. Ooh. Is he going to slip him? He's going to have to be running outside. I can't see Carson leaving the inside door open there. I don't think he's got the legs.
No, doesn't seem like...
He's on the limiter. He's on the limiter there. His both cars are absolutely flat out there. Oh, Carson.
Will they cut him? I think that's the big first mistake we've seen Carson. We've never seen Carson make a mistake before, so he's really under pressure.
Yeah, it's nice to see that somebody there has got what it takes to put Carson under it. You know, we could well see a nice little race coming our way here today. None of this 2 hours off in the lead business.
Yep. I think it's going to be difficult to open a big lead here, but you never know with Carson behind the wheel.
We've got Marius Birch coming up behind Daniel now as well, so he's trying to get back in on the action. Let's see where we are after the restart. How well we're doing. Where are we? Let's have a little looky-looky. Can you see us anywhere in the list?
I shall look now.
There we are, 20th position. That's alright then. So we've made up 4 places. Oh, it seems Carson's managed to pull away a bit there. Daniel. Too busy looking at the lifetime and to notice what's going on. And he's come back at him on the brakes. He seems to be pretty good on the brakes, doesn't he? We got a nice pack there as well. There's no teams in the pit, so it seems everybody did make a clean start, which is good. So no mishaps for any teams there.
Yeah, seems to be all going good, and going good for Luke Walsh in our cars, gaining a few positions. So qualifying didn't go according for us, qualifying in about 22nd or something, but already up, making up on time from yesterday.
We'll also be doing for the next race, although the race might take place after, through the month of March. We're going to be running some comic relief stuff on the car. So if anyone wants to donate to comic relief, please do so. You can do that by visiting their website. Donate to them. It does go to a good cause. It's certainly helps a hell of a lot of children in the UK with learning disabilities. So, if you can, please do so.
Yep, as we see, the lead is under threat again from Daniel Hacker. So, it looks like Carson doesn't have the wing on the back for the the corners, I should say. But then when he gets down to the oval, he seems to be pulling away just a little bit. And Daniel just can't get past. So, but then also Marius keeping same times as them, just making a little mistake on one of the laps there, so it'll be interesting to see if that Ferrari can pull back that little gap. Mr. Piccolo is down in 10th position.
And is he close to anyone? He's
four
tenths away. Let's have a look, see if he's bucking his ideas up at all. Oh, hang on. Hang on.
Oh, go back, go back.
That was Mr. Hackers up to no good here.
Yep.
Excuse me. This is like the real 24 hours of Daytona, isn't it? Audi seem to be running away with this one again.
Yeah, can Audi get another win around Daytona? It'll be interesting. But that Ferrari in the background looks very quick and not letting them go that far. And then the last laps, they're all pretty much even, except Daniel, who was 4 tenths quicker than our leader, Carson, so I think we'll see a move in a minute as Marius really missed the apex, locks up all the way around.
He's really, really low on the braking. But yeah, he's not locking up, that's the weird thing. I don't know how he's pulling that one off.
Yeah, we were talking to some of the drivers and they're saying they have their special setup, so maybe this special setup really helps with the braking. What, like, I found in our car when I was testing, it's so easy to lock up, and he's making it look easy. You just can't get past. So it was a good call by Carson's team to run a little bit lower wing so they can't get past.
Got a nice run coming out the bus stop though. But can he get past without bouncing on the limiter again? This is the problem. All the cars are equally matched for top end. They've all got the same engine and gearboxes. So it's, can he get past?
No, doesn't look like it. Or maybe, no, there's a limiter. Possibly.
Yep. Yeah, so we're just about to turn into turn one. He's in to go throughout the inside. No, he's back down.
No.
Cast my locker all the way through turn one. And Marius has gone wide as well. He's seems to be struggling trying to run their pace. I think he's that's what that displays there. It's, you know, running the lap times these guys are running. Yeah. I think it's, you know, I think Marius is definitely pushing right to the limit, as are the other two by the looks of it. Although Daniel seems to be quite comfortable there running that pace. So he seems to have the most stable car at the minute, although he's a lock into the rear there.
Yeah, but I don't know, it's quite interesting. In the past we've seen these guys like just let each other pass and whoever's quicker, so to be actually battling each other now is very interesting, and I think Karsten doesn't want to give up this position as they should have won 2 or 3 times in this league, but because of disconnections they couldn't win, so maybe Karsten isn't going to really listen this time and just going to keep the hammer down and try to go for victory.
Yeah, I mean, I can't see, you know, Carson's not going to make it easy for him. They may well be teammates as such, but it's 3 separate teams, so, you know, team championships are to pay for, so there's certainly going to be no favouritism. It's, I mean, maybe if Daniel does cut the inside, you know, Carson might leave him a bit more room than he normally would. Not that he's an aggressive racer anyway, as anyone knows who's seen Carson, he's about one of the cleanest guys out there, but I certainly don't see him, you know, any favourites going on there.
Yep, as they're nearly bumper to bumper at the moment. Daniel just sniffing around, might go at Carson, but takes a good decision and just backs out.
Yeah, I think we may well be waiting for a pit stop, maybe. You know, Daniel will try and undercut him or something along them lines, you know. Maybe run a little bit of a lap shorter or something, because I can't see how he's going to get past without Carson making a mistake. Carson doesn't really make mistakes.
No, not big enough mistake to put them off track anyways.
Certainly good to see. Let's have a fiddly-widdly down the field, see who else is going on. Well, these two are stealing all the limelight. Have we got any really close battles going on anywhere?
Yes, we do. Also, Jason.
Yep, we got Wychwood Call. We're only 2 tenths behind Independent Sim Racer GT1. Let's find out as well where they're getting on. With, Rocket Ronnie, where is he? There they are, down in 13th position. But they're carrying, I think it's 300 kilos of succession ballast for this event. So I was speaking to Sebastian earlier, and it equates to about 1.5 seconds around here a lap. So it's, I think they're looking, I think he said that they're aiming to sort of stay where around Wychwood Call. That's their team they're aiming to beat. So few places for them to make up to maintain their championship advantages.
Yes, and three side by side. Oh, this could be some over there on the outside by the Audi. Will he run wide though? It's very interesting. Will he all bump at each other on the exit of the first corner? It's getting very, very close here. Squeezing it onto the grass on the outside, maybe? Nope. A great racer from these guys, anyways. And the Ferrari locks up, gets hit twice by two Audis. Oh, that's not good. I think that could have been RSR getting involved there. And yeah, I think the Ferrari just locked the rear brakes up, stopped on the apex a bit too much. The Audi had nowhere to go but just tap him around, which was collected by another Audi. So, not good. So we'll go back to the leaders now for a quick second and see how they're doing. There's already a gap, 8 tenths, and it's grown as the last sector was 7 tenths. So Kirsten's on a charge, and after dropping Marius Bert in third, Jantitz in fourth position is also dropping back 3.5 seconds off the leaders. So very interesting stuff. It's actually surprising to see leaders pull this much of a gap after seeing qualifying times them being so close. So hopefully it closes up a bit more than this. So I'll give a run through the top 10. GRL have a 1-2 with Carson and Daniel. 3 wide Motorsport in 3rd position, driven by Marius Bert. 4th position, Jantit in Racing Association 2. 5th place is All Star Racing Team 1, Stefan. Team FRC, driven by Sasha, is in 6th position. 7th position, GRL, with their teammates up in 1st and 2nd, so interesting to see them go a bit down the order, but it's driven by Matthias, who is doing quick enough times, but I think that Alpina just can't keep up. In 8th position is SRC SKS, driven by Rico. 9th position, Dirk Sutter in the world, Will Grave. And in 10th position is Witchwood Cool, driven by Simone.
Yes, all certainly seems to be some good racing going on. We'll be happy if this game continues for the next 24 hours. Without a doubt, it's hotting up to be a good one. Could be just as intriguing as the real life 24 hours, which was with what's this? Oh yeah, one sec. Yeah, the real life 24 hours has just happened. It's just I think near enough a month after the real life event. And if anyone saw that was fantastic as well.
Yeah, the real Daytona was
brilliant.
And here we go, battle for the lead. Carsten really under pressure now. Yeah, so Carsten putting a cool head for the last 20 minutes or so of racing, which is really paying off now, as he still has lead by only 2 tenths. But Daniel seems to make little mistakes or has a bad lap once or twice, and but pulls it back within 2 laps. So I think it's quite clear Daniel is the quickest one, as he went 6 tenths quicker last time out. And interesting though is Carsten is the fastest person at the moment by only 6 thousandths. So yeah, GRL are by far the quickest teams, half a second quicker than 3rd place Marius Bert.
Yes, it seems to be the usual way, doesn't it, with the GRL guys, the teams to beat.
Yep.
nicely put.
Yeah. Yeah, so if any of our English viewers will please spread our stream around to get as much people watching as possible.
Yep, and also go over to the German channel and tell them to come over to ours, because we've got 32 and they've got 135, and that's just greedy.
Yep.
Even if you can't understand English, just come anyway. You'll enjoy it.
Yep, as we're still pulling away up at the front of the field, with Daniel really, really putting lots of pressure on Carson, but Carson is showing that he feels the pressure, but still able just to hang on to the lead. So I think this battle could be going on for a long, long time, but at the same time, we will want to watch it and see the overtake for the lead instead of switching to a battle down the field.
Yep, I'm definitely glad I've got my Scooby snacks for this one, although I haven't got any popcorn, fortunately.
I have popcorn somewhere. I don't know where it is, though.
Hang on. Satellite Racing, Matt Strand, position 12's only 2 tenths behind. Where's it just gone? I do wish it'd stop updating like that. Now I've lost it. Oh. No, it's gone.
Yeah, which one now is attacking?
And I've also got Luke for the broadcast team. He's only 2 tenths behind VTR for 14th place. So Luke Walsh is really pushing on. We started 24th position. So almost made up 10 places.
Yeah, really, really impressive. And this battle is basically for the championship lead, as both these teams, Independence, Simracer and Witchwood, are really like close on points. So it could get a bit dirty now with accidental bumping into walls, but it looks like clean racing.
Yeah,
around the outside.
Is he going to get him? We know that Ronnie likes to pull off some manoeuvres into turn one on most tracks, so let's see what he does here.
Yeah, and actually, if you look closely in the background, you'll see a white Ford GT driven by our very own Luke Walsh, who's actually making up so much places, it's kind of a bit of a surprise to us.
Is this going to be another Rocket Ronnie manoeuvre?
No.
No. Tried, but the door wasn't open. It's got a nice exit, though.
Hopefully these guys keep battling and let our car, which is the fourth car in this shot, right up with them.
Yeah, we're just about to make another position by the looks of things. So, this is hotting up. Who'd have thought it?
I didn't think it.
No.
So, here comes...
Come on, can I go off the ground?
Go on. No.
I don't believe it.
Oh, dear. Damn.
Ugh. Give him a little tap. Shh. Said that.
Yeah. I'm a ghost. Yeah, so Speed Hunters on the looks fairly cool.
Why have we got the Colombian flag on the car, though?
That's not Colombia. It's
ain't far off it.
Classic design for classic Daytona.
Belgium, England and Ireland.
Oh, the lead's getting very close again.
No, I don't think we're going to see anything happening until the pit stops, to be honest. Just, I can't see it happening. It just seems that no matter what Daniel tries, there's just no way past. You know, he's hitting the limiter on the straights and he can't outbrake him into the corners and can't make the gap to try and pull something off. Carson's running,
I think,
very defensive.
He needs to get a good run out of there to get up the inside here, as he's a good bit later on the brakes. Seems to get on the power better this time around, though. So this could be it.
Right, it's time for a Milky Way crispy roll, I think. Excitement's mounting.
Oh no, I hate guts. I love them things. Oh my god.
You've seen the price of them now. 50p these are now.
Jesus.
Yeah. So what's it? 65 pence. It's ridiculous. I reckon it's cheaper to go motor racing than it is to buy sweets nowadays.
Num num num. Whoa! Our car's right behind the VTR car, side by side! Perfect timing. And there we go, another position for us.
Or
oh,
is
he's gonna. That. Ooh.
Nicely done there by Mr. Walsh.
Yeah. Not
related to Tommy Walsh.
Could be.
Well, if he pulls over and starts gardening, you know he is.
Well, the way he's been messing with the grass so far this race, I think he could be related.
Oh, hang on.
Oh, give him a bump. Hit him. Oh.
You're doing really well at showing the non-bias towards our team.
Oh yeah, God, about that bit. But it's like, go on. Yeah. That's how you do a pass. Right, I think I better switch car again. Oh, All-Star Racing Team 2.
Hang on.
Oh no.
We're just
Go back. Go back. Oh, it's refreshed.
So, thanks for joining us, everybody, for the 24 hours of the broadcast team driving around data.
I think we should get a close look at our the views I can get, I think. Oh, there we go. Look at that beautiful skin. Meow. Anyways, I think I'll go to a different car now before I get sacked.
Yeah, might be an idea.
Yeah. So here we go, we're on board with All-Star Racing Team 2 by Andreas Smish. So, actually, very nice look car. Lots of sponsors, anyways.
We've made it to the first hour, although it's technically locked because we only made it to 17 minutes for hour one. So, we've done about half an hour, I think, all in them.
Yeah, gaps are already increasing. Wait, the second place car is only 0.2 off, with third place Marius actually closing in, I think, about 2.5 off. But yeah, I think we still will have good racing on our hands pretty soon. The closest battle is this battle currently. Although, as I say that, there is a battle down the field for 17th position, which is held by LSF Racer.
Yeah, there's a few teams there. Thingy bobbing, we're 0.2 beyond VTR again. So
we're behind them.
Something's gone on there. It looks like Mr. Walsh is having a good old grand occasion.
I think it's worth watching. It's the only battle that's going back and forward.
Well, coincidence.
up the inside. No, he uses his head and just backs out.
No, didn't he use the brakes, I think, was what he used.
Well, yeah. Okay, Mr. Smart Arse.
Well, you know the problem with smart asses is you always get wisecracks.
Welcome to Wayne's Comedian Show.
Hey! Well, you know, it's got to be done, innit?
Yep.
You know, as my sister always says, as a stand-up comedian, I should sit down more often.
Yeah, so Luke's after losing a bit of time, unfortunately, to the car ahead, but knowing Luke, he'll get up there again and pass him and will end up winning the race. Whoop-de-doo.
reading about a fight yesterday in the paper. Seen a dentist and a nail parlour. Yeah, he was fighting tooth and nail, apparently.
Oh my god. So, Luke misses Apex? Yeah, that's a good idea, I think.
Still four temps between Carson and Daniel. Marius is 1.4 behind, give or take. Yen Tits is 2.3 behind them. What else have we got? We got any close battles going on? Got five temps between All-Star Racing and Wychwood.
Yeah, I think we'll tune in them for the next lap.
And that seems to be a new team as well. SRC, SKS, German Craft or something. However you pronounce that. That's a mouthful, isn't it? Phew. That's driven by Rico. I want to see if we've got any regulars in on the move. As some of you may have noticed, unfortunately, we don't have Sim Racing Holland with us on this event. So they aren't partaking in the activities, unfortunately.
Yep, as we got sidelined. As we've seen, going around the outside is actually a pretty good idea, but just not near enough to make the move. What a move.
Lovely jubbly.
What a move. That's how you do it, boys and girls. Not biased at all. Not
no.
Happening.
No.
No.
I mean, we've got what? 27 teams somewhere. I don't know where they are.
Oh.
Yeah. Can only see two of them.
Okay, hold on. I was looking out.
Oh, steady, Fred.
I almost cursed.
Let's just hope he doesn't have a slap tanker.
Yeah, that'd be a bad idea. And here we go on board with Independence Sim Racer.
Yep, can
Looking
we catch him?
Back at our car.
Can we catch him? I mean, can they fall back to us?
Yes.
Carsten Willem is in second place and we've missed the overtake. Courtesy of Mr. Shane Burke.
Yes.
You're sacked.
Yep. Once again.
I can't believe that, man. This is the biggest race on here. You've been faffing about and we've missed it. Oh, dear.
Could you blame me?
So, if you're looking for a broadcasting job with us, we've got a position that's just opened.
Oh no. Marius Burt, inter position, chin up.
Yeah, so send your CVs into I'm not Shane Burke and I'm not biased.
Yeah, it looks like anyone get the job by just saying that. Ooh, Marius Burt is creeping in. He was 4/10 quicker last lap than the front two. So, race on our hands, and in fourth position, Jan Tits in Racing Association was nearly a second quicker than the leaders. So, here comes a big pull.
This fight isn't over, is it?
No.
Certainly no fat lady singing, despite the fact that we're in America.
Yeah, I'm kind of curious what's happening to Carson. He's after losing second.
Marius Burt's just caught him right up there. This could be Carson in the third position.
Yeah, it's a good job by Marius. It could be he was just looking after his tyres in the first 20 minutes, but now, after minding his tyres and the other two really were charging, maybe he has the best tyres out there at the moment.
I don't know, after that lock-up.
Yep.
Yeah, there's certainly things that will change, obviously, of R Factor 2 with the lock-ups, with the flat spotting and stuff. He seems to have a handful of car there, doesn't he, Carlson? I think he's punished the rears there. He's sliding around a lot.
Yeah, I think they're running a fairly low wing because the track's fairly hot, so they're expecting it to be okay. but maybe when the tires go off, the car's a bit of a handful, and the way their races went before, they had a big lead, so maybe they were expecting a big lead again, and so they could have dropped off, but nothing's going to plan for them.
We've got 27 degree track temperature, and we've just hit 23 hours and 29 minutes remaining, so we've just made the half hour mark. 1 hour and 15 minutes after start.
Jeez.
We're in for a long haul.
We are indeed.
So if anyone's got any sleeping bags, you know, bring them along. Because we're going to need them.
Yep. And not being biased again, Luke Walsh in the cast team has held his position.
We seem to have Jan Tits is slowly creeping up behind as well. Or small increments. So that race isn't finished yet.
Yep, I think we'll save the battle.
See him there just at the back of the picture there.
And Kirsten's attack.
Oh.
Yeah, so out of turn one,
you
all them bunched
yawning.
Up.
Make me
yawn. Yawning. It's only half an hour in. All
well, no.
We're not saying this struggle. Race is boring, it's just us. Oh, God.
Yeah, it's just because I'm old and he's a teenager.
Yep. Yeah, so Kirsten on the attack and also on the defense, so it's hard to know what do you do on the attack fully and leave the door open for Marius to put the car up the inside or do a bit of both, and which makes his job a lot harder as he has to keep an eye in his mirror and keep an eye on front. So I think hopefully these are professional enough to keep it clean.
Oh dear.
Jesus. Does someone need a nap already?
Well, I'm 31 now, and it was my birthday the other day, so it's ages catching up. Quick!
Ooh.
What's happened there?
It looks like Daniel's after breaking himself into the bus stop chicane.
And look at Marius Burtz all over the back of Carson like a cheap suit. What's going to happen there? Come on, son. Let's be having you. Carson's proper feeling the pressure here.
Yeah, but the quick speed on the straight is really helping. Look, even in draft, Marius can't do anything.
No, even with his lights flashing as well. It's quite funny as well. He's, you know, kind of police car colours as well, isn't it?
Yeah, it looks like the Italian police.
Yep, let's be having it.
Mr.
They don't pull over anyone for speeding them, look.
Sure. If you look in the background, we see Jan Tits in the Racing Association has joined the party. So a four-way battle for the lead.
Yep, that's it. We'll soon start seeing balloon animals coming.
Woohoo! Hope no clowns come, though. I'm kind of scared of clowns.
Oh, dear.
No, that wasn't a good joke, was it? I think I'll leave the joking to you.
Oh dear. This is going to be a long 24 hours.
Oh, Mary's mic up the inside. But no, it doesn't have to tweet again.
Alright. Oh, hang about. Jan's got past Daniel. So going into the bus stop, I think that took place. So it seems that Daniel's, I think he may well have used the best of his tyres.
Yeah, looks like.
And it's still going on between Marius and Carsten.
Yeah, and Carl lost position to our main rival, VR. And the gap is 2 seconds, so I think Luke's after making a bit of a mistake somewhere. As we see Daniel go up the inside. Will he get squished into the wall?
Yo!
Man, that's scary.
Phew.
And so go on board with the... What he does is the front gets
what did
very...
he just have there? What just happened there as he come out the corner, Sean?
Tank slapper. Yeah. I said to myself, I'll never say that again, but I
give him a biscuit.
Oh, no.
Yeah, there's still 23 hours and 24 minutes remaining yet for you to come out with it.
Yep, and it will happen.
Yeah, we've got Daniels now climbing all over the back now of Mr. Yen Tits. Come on. Is there anything else happening? Ooh, no. Hall wang about. It's only 3/10 between 19th and 18th.
Third place is being changed at the moment. Daniel's going up the inside and Shirley has this pulled off. Yep, no, he carried too much speed in.
Yeah, he's... Oh, here we go.
Is he going to get a run killing now? Speed. Oh, wrong camera.
There we go. He's actually gone too high. He needs to... What's he doing?
Yeah.
That's an unusual manoeuvre there, I must admit.
Yep. As we see, lead is only a tenth, but Mario still can't do anything, so... We have a battle for first, second, third, fourth.
Oh, that was a bit of argy-bargy.
Ooh, that was a close moment. Just tipping each other, and luckily they stayed on track.
Yeah, it's definitely a brown trouser moment, that one.
It was indeed.
See if we've got any messages. No. Well, what is that then?
We're popular today.
Then we've lost two viewers. Where have they gone?
Ah, oh, that's pointing.
That's it. Told you, you're going to have to get the webcam on, start taking your clothes off, that'll bring him in.
It'll get Adam in.
Yeah, it's either that or it'd lose us the other 30 viewers.
Yep. So up the inside for transition. Oh, Daniel can't do anything around the outside around here anyways. You're yawning again. Oh, some exciting racing in here. Like, oh.
I don't know what's going on, man. I was fine till you started me off.
Oh, stop talking about yawning. I need to yawn.
I stayed in bed till 11 because I didn't want to be tired. It's not even 3:30 yet. I think I've had too much sleep, and that's the problem, see? I need a nap to make up for it.
Yeah. We see Jan can... third place back, but it's the same happening all over again, getting close to the wall once again, and Daniel around the outside. Can he do anything about it? Maybe get the cut back, but no. He can't.
Carson's pulled a little bit on Marius, but not a lot. There's nothing to write home about yet.
Interesting news, our car is down in second last with a pit stop, so what's after happening there?
Yeah, it's a bit early for pit.
Yeah, did he have a pit stop? Yes, he did, so...
We're only 27 laps.
I think he's one lap down already.
Yep, it's looking that way, so... Seems that Shane's jinxed the team.
Once again.
And we also, independent sim racer GT1, they've gone right back as well. Because they was up into almost 10th position. Wonder what happened there, we've missed that one.
Yeah,
all
in
all, we're doing a good
life.
Job. Keeping everyone informed. It seems that the only place that there's really any action going on at the minute is at the front. It's always quite a bit of average of a second or two between each of the other cars, so seems like they've given up race interest for the time being. Why am I getting feedback? Oh, for goodness sake! Oh, dear.
Yeah, so here's a battle for the lead, which hasn't changed in a while. Marius is really putting pressure on Carsten, but not enough to overtake him. Seems like Carsten had a bit of a bad few minutes halfway through the race there, but getting his speed back, after letting Marius catch up him, so the lap times seem okay. Last lap was a 44.9, which is 7/10 off his best time, and it seems like everyone's kind of doing okay laps. And there's no close battles really happening except these two that we're watching at the moment. Just give a quick run through the top 10, I might as well. GRL XF Racing is leading as we see, with Carsten behind the wheel, being attacked by Marius Burt and Three Wide Motorsport Racing Association, driven by Jan Titz, is holding off Daniel Hacker, who is in 4th position driving for GRL. 5th position is All-Star Racing Team 1, is driven by Stefan. Matthias is in the GRL XF Racing 3 car, or 2 car, sorry, which is in 6th position. 7th position is Team FRC. 8th position is Wilgrave GTR 30 Team Racing, which really is really hard to say when you're trying to read out stuff quickly, so thank you guys for making my job tough. And here's an even tougher name in 9th position, SRC, SKC, or SKS, Fergus Mishnifner. Them guys are driven by Rico in 9th position. 10th place is also Racing Team 2, which has an easy name to pronounce, so thank you guys.
Oh dear.
And there you go, you're 10. See, I don't know how I still have this job.
Oh dear, I'm wondering the very same thing. Yeah, so in 9th place we have Team Oh dear. Yes, well, I can see, you know, BBC ringing you up to fill in David Coulthard's position any time now.
Yes. Obviously, why wouldn't you? I can pronounce anything.
Yep, that's it. Well, you don't get much closer than that. Oh.
Yeah, gap was 81 hundredths.
Oh, it's just not happening, is it?
Nope. I think what would be a good idea if Marius uses Carsten as a brake. That would be...
Good sound advice there.
Yep. But... yeah, at least it's more exciting than our last race, which was at Eastern Creek, which was won by Arnold. Actually, another thing is pits could be coming in soon, as we have Witchwood in the pit, we had Independent Sim Racer in the pit, Game SR Gaming in the pit, I think possibly VTR was in the pit, RML was in the pit, so... maybe it's nearly time to make a quick splash and dash. Gant Hits is back. Yeah.
Daniel seems to be holding station 4th place there. So I think he's just sitting back, taking stock just for a minute.
Yep. Taking a lot of curb and grass there, and a bit of a sleeping policeman.
Yeah, he wants to stay on the grey stuff.
Yeah. Well, here we go again. Marius will end up basically pushing Carson all the way around for this second, as he can't get past him because the top speed just isn't there. Will he dive up the inside? No. Dive up the outside? No.
Who was that?
Where did he come from?
It was an Audi, that was for certain.
I'll try to figure out who it was.
Probably.
Certainly not.
We've got X Factor Racing Team 2 in the pits. No, they're not. Yes, they ain't. Yep, it is. We've also got that one that you like. That SRC SKS team. There it is. So I'm wondering whether it was them. And we've also got Witchwood Call in the pits now as well.
Yeah, just trying to figure out who the hell is that car.
And that's it there. There he is. They're off again.
Oh. I'm after switching by accident.
Go back one, go back one.
Yeah, go back, go back. Who was that? 27. Yeah, so that's last place car that's gone off everywhere. And, gets propped off the track there.
He's probably got damage after nerfing the tar wall there into turn one, so he's probably, that's it, down in the apron, well done. So he's obviously sustained steering damage.
Yep, it's been driven by Sean Yoder from the United States, I believe. So, fairly early morning for him.
Obviously lost the back end on reckoning going into turn one and nerfed the wall. We've all done that a few times around here.
Getting really closed up and stays down and gets tanked by the other Audi. So, yeah, nice looking livery. Will he pull into the pits now? Interesting.
He's coming.
Yep, so we'll watch the pits up for let everyone see the pit crew flat out at work.
All-Star Racing Team 1 are in the pits. Free Wide Motorsport are in the pits. Wilgrave are in the pits. And who else? Someone else is in the pits and all. There's four there. So Independent. Oh! Ronnie Hannell's pitted.
What position is he in?
And they're all coming in now.
Yep, even Mary's Burt is in there.
Yep. So, that's Sakowitz, they're in, and Lazy Man, by the looks of it. So, it seems that it's that time. So, you're looking at around 32 to 33 laps on a stint then, so that's that written. Ooh! A bit wide on the cold tyres.
Yeah, very lucky to hold it.
Yeah, these cars are a handful on the cold tyres. The good thing is with the banking, it only takes like half a lap for them to come up to temperature.
Yeah, and I think we seen Marius in the pits a bit early there, so I think maybe use some boost 2 or 3 for a bit longer than Kirsten, who was driving on 1, so this could be one in pit stops this race. Yeah, so a nice looking livery there with the Nordschleife track, which is based in Germany as their livery. And I think Saving Group is somewhere on that car, which is a group you should definitely look up on Facebook and Twitter, or even Google them, Save the Ring. Basically, a bunch of guys just trying to save the ring from disappearing into someone else's hands and probably destroying it, as it could be going up for sale. Not quite sure what's happening, and if you're interested in helping these guys out, sure, I say they would appreciate it hugely.
I will indeed.
Yep.
All the timing's a bit of a hoo-ha at the minute as all the teams are stopping. I've got Team FRC have pitted, and GP Racing Team are now in the pits as well. All Star are still in there. They've been in there quite a while.
Actually, I think we have a transfer which could be second position, Jan Tits, after overtaking Marius in the pits, so.
Yep. Everyone's stopped now except Carsten, according to the timing. Carsten's in.
Yeah, so is Daniel Hacker, so.
Yep, that's everyone in now then. That ain't too bad. He had 35 laps he managed. They're the only two that have managed that. Although technically it's 34 in it because they had to cross the line as they're in the pit lane, so.
Yeah, so just watching the guys save, I think made a pit stop much earlier than anyone else, so running a different strategy, so we could see them end up dicing with the leaders, even though it's not really for position.
And there they are, line astern. And can Carsten hold on to first, and can Daniel come out in second?
Yeah, it'll be interesting now to see who comes out first, as we could have a change for the lead any second now.
Oh!
No, there we go, Carsten and Daniel.
Who's that there?
Ooh, there's Marijan. This is all a battle for the lead. Who will come out? And it looks like Jan Tits will to lead.
He's
from
got it.
Carsten, yeah. Fantastic
damn,
stuff.
Third to first. Nicely done.
Yeah, and that's an Audi in the mix of it. I think he's a lap down possibly, but yeah, that's the lead change. And actually, it's not even the lead. That's for second place, as we have Rico in the SRC Audi, I think it is, up in the lead. So.
Yeah, and they pitted a couple of laps ago, so. Oh, that's interesting. Ooh. How did they manage that? They was in ninth place.
I think they put it... Well, yeah, how did they manage it, really?
How can you jump nine places? Interesting. Yeah, keep an eye on that one, because that's quite weird. Which would call in the pits. So. Ooh! I think Ronnie Hannell's had an issue. Because he is still in the pits and he's down in all but one place.
Disconnected.
Yes, that's unfortunate for them, so their race is going from bad to worse.
Yeah, unfortunately.
That's not doing their championship any good.
And Matthias in the URL XF Racing 2, which is teammate to Carsten here, is down basically in last position. So yeah, not going good, and... Our broadcast team car is up 16th position. So, just an early pit stop for us, I guess.
Yeah, and we lost a few places there then.
Yeah.
As we was in 14th before that took place, so there's certainly somebody going quick on the thing. It seems Marius Burt's already on the attack with Carsten again, so they've picked up where they left off.
I think Marius should have really risked on overtaking him while his tyres were hot, and now Carsten with his tyres, I say give them a lap or two and they'll be back up temperature, and makes Marius' jobs a bit more difficult than it should be, so I think it would have been nearly worth the risk just overtaking while his tyres were in a better condition.
Yeah, I'm still baffled to understand how Rico's jumped nine places. I can't get my head around that at all.
No, it's very confusing.
Because he was like, he was about 6 or 7 seconds back.
Yeah, his times aren't quick enough really to close the gap to the leaders also, so... Quite interesting how he'd gain that much time.
His best lap time so far today is a 1:45.0. Whereas when you look at Jan and Carsten and all that, you know, they're 44 twos and sixes, so it's, you know, he's almost a second, not even on the last lap. He was just shy of a second slower than the others, so I can't get my head around that at all.
Quite interesting, but I say it's been looked into.
Yeah, I think we'll have to watch that one with anticipation. It's either something's gone wrong with the timing or they've pulled some sort of master plan and managed to jump them all. With the lap times he's doing, I don't think they'll be long in getting back past. So he's losing about a second a lap. He's only just about 7 tenths in front now, so give him another few laps. I reckon Jan will be all over him like a cheap suit.
Yep. So Jan really pushing at his limits at the moment to try to get this lead and pull a massive gap to Karsten, who's in basically second position because this car isn't really fighting for position. Well, it is in a way, but we think he'll be soon enough, I think, but I don't know. Very confused at the moment of where this car should be in the race, and basically you're looking at your Jan Tietz being the leader, Karsten in second and Marius Bert in third. So big enough gap to second place. And woo!
Oh, he was being pinched.
Just a bish, but makes the move and over a sleeping policeman. Will he get a penalty for that now?
You got a wobble coming on, that's what you got for that.
Yep. And we'll watch the Audi attack now.
That's a nice livery, that.
Yeah, it's quite nice. It looks like the Audi doesn't have this. So side by side, around the Daytona oval part, will the Audi try and make for an outside, but no choice, sneaks up the inside and can't do it. So that looks like Jan could be on his way to a big, big gap lead, since he's a good bit quicker than Karsten. Although, saying that, he was almost a second slower up because of the battling going on. Yeah, so here's the battle with Karsten, really, really close up behind this SRC SKS car, with Marius right behind Boo Carson cutting the corner basically, so might get in trouble for that. Hopefully not.
Shit. Have we got any other action going on? I don't think we have.
Marius might bump draft him a bit.
We got independent sim racer only 0.1 behind Witchwood now. So that's Sim Racer GT1 though, that's not Rocket Ronnie. Ronnie's still in the pits.
Maybe there's a penalty to be served or something.
Well, I don't know, they're what, 4 laps down now, so they've got big issues there, way.
Yeah.
I think it's only 6 minutes, I think the penalty is, so that's they've been in there a good wee while now.
Unfortunately.
Maybe they're deciding to retire, perhaps, which you can't see. And what's the back?
No, I doubt it.
They'll play it as their Joker card if the worst comes to the worst.
Yep. So the lead is on by the corner, which it's around 2 seconds from Jan Karsten, but there's a four-way battle now for second position, and Karsten really hold these guys up in the midsection because of his low wing for the oval part.
Yeah, and we're down to 23 hours remaining.
Wow.
We've made 1 hour.
Oop-de-doo.
Buckle up.
Yep. Yeah, so here goes Marius again. For the 100th time I've said this. And he will go right behind him and not pull out of his slipstream because he simply ain't quick enough.
LSF, 0.5 behind Lazy Man now as well. So they're into a battle. And yep. Racing Association 1 are just behind RML Racing Team 1. That's about the closest battles we've got at the minute. Still going on between All Star and Witchwood.
So we'll see what's happening down the end of the field. Something interesting, and now it seems like Ronnie Hanel in the independent sim racer after disconnect is still in the pits, unfortunately, and with the time penalty around you, you lose so many laps, but an Urshclef, the penalty will only lose you track time and not position. Well, of course, it depends on whereabouts you were on track and how quickly you rejoined, but at least in Urshclef you won't lose a lap possibly, but here basically one disconnect and it's game over. What else is happening in the field? Ryan Walker seems to be a good few laps down in Satellite Racing 1. Matthias in the GRL is a lot down. RML, who was winners at the last race, are down the field too.
Yep, and yeah, so Ronnie's out the pits now, so whatever issue they've had, it's now gone.
Yep. Actually, just looked where people started in qualifying. John Titz started in 11th position and has the lead within 1 hour, so that's an unbelievable drive from him.
It is indeed. Have to get him in our team.
Yeah, where did we qualify? Doop-a-doop-a-doo. We qualified and it just refreshed. Durr. We qualified 22nd, they're now 16th, so not bad.
We're doing alright.
Yep. So I think we'll go to All-Star for a wee while to watch a new battle. Yeah, so nice looking livery. Very mean kind of look. So the lead is up to 3 seconds. Carson really dropping behind. And these boys are really at it as Andreas is really attacking Alex Piccolo in the Witchwood car. Yeah, so if anyone has questions or wants a shout out or anything, make sure to contact me on Twitter at TheRealSB or on Facebook / The Broadcast Team, and we'll give you a shout out or if you have any questions. And what we have planned for later on this evening is probably have a good look at this mod, different cars, and just talk about, like, we've driven basically all them testing for this event, so we'll talk you through and what the different cars are like, and might go into talk about different teams, and I've certainly some news from my team, Simtech Motorsports, so I'll update people with that as it's kind of big and interesting news. And we'll talk about real world racing, as in F1 to testing, some GT racing, and Toyota's new Le Mans car, which is basically only an update. All that for later on, but at the moment, while there's still action happening, we will focus on the sim racing.
Yeah, I'm just reading here that, I don't know if people had seen the story that Logitech might have been pulling out of the market. They've, Sean and Dan from Inside Sim Racing, have asked Logitech what their standpoint is, and it seems that Logitech will remain in with their quote, the PC gaming is a growing in Logitech as a strong core peripherals for the market. If a gaming peripheral works with a PC, it would be included as part of our strategic focus. Which basically means, it's like it says, leaves the question to be asked, when will the Logitech G29 be unveiled to take the flight to Fanatec Thrustmaster? And just reading through a few of the comments, a few people saying, a lot of us agree, they might not be the top of the range wheels, but they're dependable and they're cheap and they work fantastically, so that's certainly good news for all us Logitech owners.
Yeah, I have a Logitech for now 3 years, I think it is, the G27, and never let me down, I think. With old age now, it's just getting a little bit worn out, but oh, it's a great product, and glad I chose that as my frill.
Yep, yeah, I've got the 27 and the 25, and I swear by them both. Fantastic wheels. Never had many, you know, major issues with them. Normally you get a bit of dust or something in one of the sensors, which is easily sorted. It's certainly good news. And Seto Corsa, for those of you that are interested in that, the latest news on that is the technology preview demo is now available. So, we'll have a... It's minimum PC requirements for this is Windows Vista 7 or 8. Minimum CPU is an Intel Celeron. RAM is 2 GB. And a Direct 11 graphics card compatible. So obviously it's been powered by DirectX 11. I don't know, it says here the technology previews allow sim racers to try the Lotus Elise SC at a laser scanned Gaian circuit. The technology preview requires a Netcar Pro activation code. Netcar Pro is currently available for a reduced price of €499. There you go.
Yeah, Netcar Pro is definitely grabbing now, as it's only 5 year on. Oh, it's a fantastic game. Even though a set of courses coming out, it gives you a feeling of what a set of courses will be like, so it's well worth it. And actually, a set of Netcar Pro was one of my first games. I got R Factor, then Netcar, only demo unfortunately, couldn't really afford the game, but even in demo, it was fantastic. But I think the real downfall of that game is there's not enough people really in it.
Yeah, I mean, I bought it. It's, the things that annoyed me with it was some of the sound effects leave a lot to be desired, and there's no offline on it at all. And a lot of the online races, because they're public rooms, you tend to just end up with the ramming rooms, and you know, when you want to race properly, you kind of get fed up with the idiots, to be honest. So I haven't played it in well over a year now, but I may well get this technology demo and see what a set of courses like. Cause, you know, it's been one of those games a lot of sim racers have been following in development now since it was announced last year.
They've got
a video preview as well, and this is all this information I'm bringing to you from virtualr.net, the sim racing news site, if anyone's interested and wanting to take a look.
Yeah, it looks like good weight transfer, as I haven't seen a good similar game with proper decent weight transfer and good suspension movement, but it seems to be kind of as perfect balance as we see Marius Bert trying to get past Karsten. So close, and I say he's very, very, very tempted just to dive it up the inside, but these guys have great respect for each other, and I'm doubting they'll take each other out.
Yep, and then also this week, if anyone saw the live show on Wednesday evening, the PlayStation 4 was sort of officially, unofficially launched with a couple of driving titles they showed there. Was one was that Drive Club, which looks absolutely fantastic. It's certainly something that I'll be considering for my future gaming experiences.
Yeah, it looks fairly decent, but is it street racing or track racing?
It's neither. It's by going by what the development has said during the video feed. It's open environment, a lot like, if people are familiar with test drive, it's like a three-wheel driving experience. But what it's all about is you have clubs of racing, you can set up events like to race across certain locations, and as you do so, there's challenges to be performed on the way. So it's kind of like test drive mixed with burnout, mixed with Gran Turismo. It's sort of, they've merged all aspects together to make what looks to be quite something special.
Yeah, graphics looking real, but you can't be really tricked by the graphics. Could be great graphics, but it could be diabolical physics.
Yep, although saying that, it is being done by Evolution Studios, and if anyone knows of them as I do, they was the people that bought us the WRC games back on the PlayStation 2, and they're also the guys behind MotorStorm, which were awesome games. So generally physics wise, while going by their WRC stuff, was pretty second to none, so I can't see them having bad physics, but only time will tell. And obviously we've also got GT6 to look forward to as well, coming on that, and then all the others, I should imagine Codemasters will probably bring, knowing that Grid 2's coming, I imagine they'll maybe port that over or do a Grid 3 for that next year, and then the Dirt Games if they decide to continue that franchise. So, and then obviously with Formula 1 2013, I imagine, probably come out in the PS3 first with a possible port to the 4. Certainly some, you know, looking good for racing games for the next 12 months. Obviously a set of course will be released this year. We're expecting R-Factor 2 to be finally released this year, with the news that they're now releasing certain parts of that game now as standalone mods, part of their release procedure apparently. And then Project Cars could well be here this side of Christmas as well. So for us racing game fans, there's certainly a lot to be looking forward to this year. Oh, we've got a...
Ooh, that's a leader, is it? Or is his teammate?
Come on, update. Yeah, it's the teammate, yeah. Nicely spinning to the bus stop there.
Yep.
So, where are they on the list? We want Racing Association 1, where are you? there, down in 21st position.
Doesn't help anything spinning out in front of your teammates who are leading the race.
No, I should imagine it was a bit of a fright now.
Yep. And the broadcast team is in the 15th position.
And we've got 8 tenths of a gap between Lazy Man and... no, it's not. It's LSF Racer and us. It's all going off for us. 15th and 16th position. And we have got Lazy Man and RML tossing between 8 tenths and a second. Clever than the leading pack, the closest battles at the minute. Although,
yeah, so we're watching it now, I think, or we're not.
Team FLC are only 3 tenths behind SRC SKS team.
Yep. Now, so here's the broadcast team, chased down by SF Racer, driven by Julian. So hopefully that won't be a battle, and hopefully Luke just pulls away because I'm not biased at all. Anyways, I think we'll go to Team FRC, as that's a good battle now. And they're sticking with Alpina for this race, after most teams that are using Alpina after switching to Audis. So they're sticking by their car, and that's good for them.
It is indeed. It's always handy when you stick with the same car, you know, it's less to get used to.
Yep. Well, here goes a pass around outside, possibly. Or maybe not. Or maybe so. Yes, it is. Oh. He does have enough speed. And will he... But that's independent sim racer possibly getting in the way. No. Can't. Will he turn it in the inside? No, he does.
Oh,
no.
Dearie me. That was a driving incident, that one. I think can really be helped.
Yeah. No, there's nothing you could do there. Luckily, it wasn't too much damage and he hasn't lost his splitter, so he should be okay.
Yeah, I don't think he sustained too much damage there. I think it was probably mostly cosmetic, if anything.
New paint job and it'll be grand.
Alright. Seems to be pulling away, so don't have any damage.
Yeah, seems to be fairly easy actually. It's driven by Andrea Gullner, so he's really on the pace at the moment. Decent times actually, last lap 44.8, which is basically what the leaders are kind of doing, so he has good pace and his quickest lap time is pretty much around the leaders as well, so I think we should be watching out for this guy maybe in the latter part of the race.
Yeah, it seems, you know, Jan's maintaining the 1 second gap over Carsten. I was kind of thinking that maybe Carsten and that would start reeling him in, but although saying that, he's just jumped to 3 tenths, so I'm thinking Jan's had a mistake somewhere.
Looks like Carsten's after pulling the gap to Marius, so Carsten changing his tactics a bit. Instead of pushing really hard at the start, this time he just took it easy to have the best tires for the second part of his stint. Well, a big lock up there from Jan Hitz, really pushing hard, but I think he's after destroying his tires in his first stint. It'll be interesting to see this battle now, as these guys have been in a bit of trouble in the test races with penalties and Jovan being one of their main drivers being suspended, so it'll be interesting to see how these guys do now for 24 hours without one of their main drivers.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see.
Yeah, and attack now is quicker. Well, indeed.
And we're up to 1 hour, 15 minutes in.
Oh, time's gone so slowly.
It is, isn't it? I looked, I was expecting this to see 3 hours in. Yeah, 22 hours and 42 minutes remaining.
Yeah, it's a bad thing about the track, because the laps are kind of so short. And it's been a 24-hour race, and we're just watching him go round and round and round so quickly, expecting more time to be gone. But like with Le Mans, it takes such a long time to get round, and kind of time flies watching it. But being a small track, it's hard.
And the ring, because obviously it's like an 8-minute lap, so you know, after 8 laps, it's about an hour, so you're all right.
Exactly. Oh, time flies when you're doing Nurg.
50 laps we've done so far.
Exactly. Jeez, only 50 laps. I was kind of expecting a bit more.
Yeah, I reckon we could well be into, with 50 laps in an hour and 15, I reckon we could be looking at maybe 600-700 laps by the end of the 24 hours.
Is it that bad, actually? Yeah, so let's see anything interesting happen. Lazy Man are attacking RML. So we'll go watch that now. There's Lazy Man in the yellow and black Lamborghini, which isn't much of them lying around the place. Yeah, so Lazy Man, guys based down in Australia, take part in... G'day, mate. Put on the barbecue. Can't do it much, no. That really sucks.
What was that?
I don't know. I just destroyed it.
Sounded like a dyslexic sheep. You can't even do that right. Is it meh? What's that? Fucking sheep with no lips.
It's a special sheep. They should do like messed up animal noises and people
yeah,
can guess
that'll
what
be
they
shame when he has kids, he'll be like, what does a sound as a cow make? And he'll be going, ooh, like that. kids will be like, no, daddy, that's wrong.
Oh, I'd be some pet.
Yeah, I know, it's shocking to think that one day we're going to be blessed with some of your offspring.
Oh, God.
Although I've got a few out in the world myself.
Yeah.
I'm saying nothing.
Think that's a smart idea.
No, they're all perfectly normal.
Yeah.
Oh. you ask any of my family that see them, you know, they'll say that they are the perfect example of children.
Seeing is believing.
yeah, this is true.
And yeah, nice view here. Lazy man getting really attacked by, I think could be RSR, but basically in a different country at the moment. But daddy doesn't find a way. Oh, he does. Ooh, that was very close. I think lazy men racing were trying to find a way back home again there, as they're getting lapped by the leaders. And as we can see, the lead is only 1/10 of a second there. What animal was that? A tractor animal.
Oh dear.
And here's a car getting lapped or something, being very, very, very kind, basically stopping. I'm trying to get a good view, maybe not. There we go. Yeah, so I think that's enough of watching the Aussies go round and round and round. We'll go back to the leaders for a quick minute or two.
What's going on here?
What?
Hey. Carlson's just got past, didn't he?
What?
No. Thought we had for a minute there.
God. Ooh. That was very close for the leader there. Oh, is that him around? Who is that? It is. That's the leader gone. Spun in turn one.
Oh, dear. He's down
and
the
so
third.
And so someone else.
Yep, that's
someone else spun it there.
Now, so.
I have a bad feeling that was our curse.
No, we haven't. Okay. We have. We're
no, we're
23rd.
Another side track. Oh, what? I think we just made it stop. Yeah,
we did. Again? Yeah. It calls first, didn't it?
Ah.
I told you to use the R8, didn't I?
Takes over.
Told you to use a different car, so you wouldn't listen.
No.
It calls way too thirsty.
Yeah, looks like it, but... Yeah, we have Nico in the car now, after James... Or, not James, Luke doing a great stint. He's... Tiredness already getting in, and it's only an hour and something gone. I don't know. I do not know. Oh, jeez. Wayne, you're some comedian.
I'll try.
Yeah, we'll get Wayne to tell his funny jokes after 9 o'clock as they kind of sound a bit dirty.
That wasn't dirty, that was a clean one.
Well, Okay, tell everyone your joke then.
You tell it. Now, I'll send you a new one.
Why are men like cars? Because they always pull out before they check to see if anyone... Oh my god.
You didn't read that before you read it, did you? Oh dear.
Yeah, we'll read that one after.
Yes, Jan's now in fourth place. Be fuming after that.
Yeah.
Goes to show that slight lapse in concentration, you know, pushing a tad too hard, and that turn one can be a ferocious monkey.
It can indeed. We have not much time, action happening. Feels like it, actually.
Oh no.
At least it's not as, or at least the gaps ain't as big as they were in Eastern Creek. Whoa, what now? Oh, Jesus Christ. Think Wayne's just gone to lose everyone, so if you're looking for a job, come train with me. Please just send your name and address or whatever in and yeah. What's funny?
Oh dear, that's a good one.
Oh, you're looking at Joe.
There you go.
Okay. Oh my god. Yeah, I think we'll definitely read these jokes out after 9 o'clock, possibly 12 o'clock. 12 p.m. at night.
Yeah, when you got well, another
kids are going to bed, hopefully.
8 hours to go, I think.
Jesus, that's a long time.
Yep, so we've got 22 hours and 31 minutes remaining.
Track is dropping temperature down to 26.9, so maybe it's going to get dark fairly soon.
Yep, laps completed, 55. And we've got a yellow flag in sector 2.
I'll try find...
And we're down in 24th position.
Yeah, it shows how tight the field is down in the second half of it as you make a pit stop when you basically drop 10 positions, so...
And we've got VTR in the pits.
Here comes the pit stop, and...
Yeah, we're getting into the window. It's, what, 33 laps, so... We're getting there. And you'll start seeing some of them come in now.
Good battle going on here. Lappin, think, which is last place. But at least they're not a sore losers of guys and not leaving the server because they're in last, or they mightn't even be in last. It just looks familiar. Off the car that was smacked the wall a while ago. many messages.
On Facebook.
Yeah, just on that myself. And Luke, who was driving the press car, just posted that not very happy with his stint after making a few mistakes, but why are we going back to the... Is there a disconnection? No, it's not. Just gump to our car. There we go.
There we go.
Back with Mary's Bert. Yeah, so Luke, happy with a few mistakes, but we think you've done a great job gaining us about 8 positions, we think.
Yeah, he's done a brilliant job. There's not really anything close action going on at all.
I know, from when they all came to the pits, it was like a race.
Hang on. Lazy Man Racing. 17th position. They seem to, according to the timing screen, they're only a tenth behind. See if that's true. No, it's not.
Nah, I'm selecting all wrong cars possible.
Yeah, you are.
Here we go.
Yeah, well, that certainly ain't one of a second, is it? Not unless the car they're chasing is invisible. More than 3 seconds. Oh, good old live timing.
Yep, can't beat it.
You can, watch.
I think we'll give Witchwood a bit of air time, as I think we just caught them making a miss there.
Yep, so have you got any stories or anything you want to talk about? Let us know on Facebook. As the racing event goes on, we'll definitely be looking for stuff to discuss. I don't know whether Mr. Berkey Baby Boy's got anything to talk about.
I guess I tell people what my team's up to for the next few months. We are preparing for GTR 24-hour race, which is held in Denmark. It's I think it's the world's biggest LAN event. About 28 teams, all driver swaps nearly, so everyone's together in one hall, and you have two halls basically separated, so you have one dark hall, so you have drivers in there and stuff like that. And then another hall for all your computers and the kind of the tent, so you put all your computers in there, and basically like the real life Le Mans but just simulated. That's held on the GTR2 game, so it's been held on that game for the last few years, so I think it's fairly reliable. Even Mr. Lutz, who runs this championship, is a commentator for it, as we're on top. We are watching a car go to the pit. Lazy Man Racing in the pits. Anyways, it's not Lazy Man, that's Witchwood Cool. But anyways, again, what are we doing? We have me in this, we have Alexander, we have Thomas and Adam, as we are competing in the GTE class, and it's between the Ford GT and Chevy, so not quite sure yet. And if anyone would love to sponsor us, please contact us, as it's costing me an arm and a leg. And then we're going from virtual to reality for next year, as we are preparing for the EPEC Le Mans 24-hour kart race, which is in real life. Oh, you could end up actually doing, which I would feel really bad. But yeah, so that'll be interesting to see. Can sim racers really prove that they're quick in karts? And they're, unfortunately, it's only rental karts, but the competition is so high at this event, and so many people have so much experience at it, so it'd be very challenging to even get top 5, and thankfully my team is training really hard. We have me again, Thomas, Alexander, Nico, Luke, Jordan, I'll get shot if I forget people now, though I will go and double check. We have Michael or something from France. So
just hearing from Jan. I asked him what caused this spin. He says he had a TV glitch with the cabling that caused him to By the time the pitcher came back, it was halfway around the corner, so obviously broke really hard and spun the car, so that's why Jan had an accident.
Okay. But then we have, who else do we have? So we have Will and Dimitri joining us, so that's another event I will need plenty of sponsors for, and if anyone's interested in sponsoring us, you would get all the advertising as you'd want for free. Well, not for free, actually. Yeah. Kind of basically messing up everything I'm saying, so...
Yeah, I was going to say,
okay, you have to pay for space and our Arfa crashed.
What?
So, we're going...
What have you done now?
I've done nothing now.
Oh, see, I'll leave you for 10 seconds. Free for... Hey.
Yeah, so that's all that my team's doing for the next year or two. So, if anyone's interested in our projects of going to Denmark or going to Le Mans, you'll find me on the SimTech Facebook page at www.facebook.com/SimTech Motorsport. No, I don't think we're joining that for now. Broadcast some EC200 or something.
Right, and what we'll do when we get there, we'll do a quick server restart. Coming up to the 2.5 hour mark. Oh, yes, hang on, Facebook, I'm coming. A message left, right, and centre. This is what I mean, so I'll go off to see what's going on, and come back and you've blown the bloody server up.
Yep.
Can't be trusted.
Nope.
Move. There we go. Alright, let's do a quick...
Now you're breaking this.
Right, let's do a quick server restart. We'll be... What are you doing?
Yeah, I was like, yeah, okay, I'll leave that alone.
Oh, dear. Right, we'll be back in a...